This video will illustrate methods to take accurate power measurements. The video begins after powering the CX300 up in factory default conditions. First, it is important to ensure that the power meter user calibration has been performed. To do this, select Normalize at the bottom of the test screen. Choose Full to calibrate over the entire frequency range of the CX300 and select the Start button. This normalization procedure will calibrate the in-band power meter to achieve the most accurate power measurements. After the calibration is complete, we will change some of the default settings before we test the power meter. By default, the CX300 input and output ports are not routed to the duplex port, so we will change that first. Now, enable the level offset field for the RF signal generator. Then choose one of the stored cables for use. Now, do the same thing for the RF receiver. Now, I will expand the channel analyzer to choose a more appropriate top of scale for viewing a transmitter signal. The CX300 offers an N-band power meter, so the receiver must be set to the transmitter frequency in order to measure power. Using a pre-configured frequency list can make this an easy task if you work with the same frequencies commonly. I will now key the transmitter and change my power meter units from dBm to watts. This radio is expected to transmit at 2.6 watts in the 700 MHz band. In the 800 MHz band, this radio is expected to transmit at 3.3 watts. The cable compensation automatically corrects the power meter for the cable loss at each frequency.